What's up, you guys? It's your girl Glowing, back at it again with a brand new video. And welcome to episode 9 of Mass Effect Andromeda. Right? One sec. Oh, I don't remember. Yes, episode 9 it is. So, yeah, we're most likely gonna come back to Eos instantly. So fine, just so I can be able to save whenever I want, let's just do this. Running around Nexus. I think it's only part 2.
Ascent is go.
Leaving Atmel. All clear.
Oh, loading screens, loading screens, loading screens. I hate loading screens. So, how's the weather, guys? Great? Well, the loading screen? Oh, you know, it's just loading. It's been loading. I wish it would be done loading. Yes, I hear sound.
Before the meeting gets started, I have bunk assignments for PB and Drac.
Already put my rucksack in the kitchen. I'll hang out there if that's okay.
And I'm in one of the escape pods. More my speed. That's fantastic. Welcome aboard. Any thoughts, Ryder? You're professionals. I'm not going to babysit bunk assignments. Let's talk about our success on Eos. Besides establishing our first viable outpost, we did some amazing things. We discovered the Remnant and breached their vault.
And didn't get killed.
Overcame radiation poisoning a number of times.
And didn't die.
Confronted by Ket at every turn.
Once again, did not get killed.
You guys really need to raise the bar on what you call success.
Yeah, should we use the Krogan definition of success that got your homeworld nuked by your own people?
Whoa.
Fair enough.
Hey, I guess you can take a joke, but that's pushing
it. Let's focus.
It.
Back to the task at hand. Looking forward.
Exactly. Here's my only question. When do we hit that next vault? It looked active. We have to get on that.
Hang on, hang on. We need to not go off half-cocked.
There are initiative priorities. The team calls the shots.
Actually, the Pathfinder calls the shots. Just to be clear.
Hey, that's me.
So what do you need from us, Ryder?
Please just get along.
Let's be kind and give each other the benefit of the doubt. Finding a home for tens of thousands in this hellscape is stressful enough without adding dysfunction.
You got it, boss.
If Krogan are known for one thing, it's getting along.
I'm sure
they not are. Humility or self-awareness. Okay, let's head back to the Nexus. PB, Drac, see Lexi for a physical? Good meeting, everyone.
Aw, poor Ryder. Oh, I'll figure it out somehow. I guess I should go talk to my bunk members? I don't know.
Hey, can you drop by the biolab?
Nice place you found. Clean air.
Alright, we're back. Sorry, guys.
What the hell was that? I know that look. It's just my biotics reacting to all this. I don't normally lose it like that. A huntress should have better control.
Huntress?
Another term for an Asari commando. I was one before the initiative. Some things stick, though. Like losing the old man.
How does a human soldier get to serve with Asari?
Yeah.
Prove your biotics can rip an APC apart, and people get nervous. Funny that. The Alliance found me a cross-species military initiative in a hurry. Sent me to Thessia to serve with the Huntress
unit.
That's
pretty cool.
One of the few places where my powers were welcomed. Your father made another one.
You were his second in command. Were you friends too?
He was more a mentor than a friend. Prickly old bastard. But I respected that. People treat geniuses like they're made of cut glass. I didn't care how smart he was. I think he liked someone not caring.
I know it's not the same, but I'm a good listener.
I hope you're as good at being Pathfinder. I said I wouldn't get in the way, and I meant it. But I prepped for years as your father's second. Then he chooses you.
Okay.
An untrained Pathfinder and all this mess to fix? The hell was he thinking?
That's a little rude.
Is this going to be a problem, Cora?
I don't want a rival. Just answers. It's done. Best I can do now is be your second. Keep your father's mission alive. Then maybe we'll all get what we came out here for.
I don't want a romancer.
So what brought you out to Andromeda?
Biotics like this. Thinking like an Asari huntress. I never had a place. Best I could be was a useful freak. The initiative was meant to be different. Will be different if this mission succeeds. So I'm seeing it through. It's quiet in here. I can keep the plants watered while I work. First job, see if there's any news on the Asari Ark. If they made it, we could use some Asari expertise. If you want to talk, I'll be here.
Oh, yeah.
Hi there.
How's the search for the Asari Ark going?
The Lucinia? Checking every comm that's coming in. Nothing concrete yet.
What did you do while you were part of the Asari military?
4 years in a commando unit called Talane's Daughters. Part of the Council's cross-species military integration initiative. Your time defending Silva's expedition was probably more important. But we did good work. Peacekeeping is a full-time job, even in Asari space.
What was your commando unit like?
Janae and I were the youngsters. Tethys was our old lady sniper. Callia patched us up, and Valenza prayed between firefights. Our CO, Nasira, led us all over the Athena Nebula and beyond. A huntress's work is never done.
Every civilization needs its defenders.
And the defenders usually match their civilization, like Asari huntresses being adaptable as hell. Makes you wonder what our militia will look like in 100 years.
You were in the Alliance before you became a huntress, right? What made you join up?
My biotics. I was still living on my parents' cargo freighter when they manifested.
Oh.
Untrained biotic power on a starship means accidents. But we couldn't afford a tutor. The Alliance had implants, the training, everything. Old history now. Your turn. Remind me why you came to Andromeda.
Ooh. The Prothean digs woke us up to how much we don't know, and to what humanity's next leap might be. Then Dad's career collapsed. His AI research made him too toxic.
I heard. Must have changed everything for your family.
We needed to start over somewhere new. Together. Or as together as we could. So, Andromeda.
None of you writers ever think small, do you?
Nope.
Did you come out here with anyone?
Maybe someone you served with?
I had my fun on shore leave. Nothing serious, though. Sorry, Huntresses. Figure things out. But I was there for soldiering, not romance.
Does that mean fraternization is okay for Asari commandos?
It'll happen, but usually only for one deployment. Asari don't usually stay with each other long term. After your 500th birthday, you learn some self-control.
Oh. After 4 years with Asari commandos, he must have some great war stories.
Nasira assassinated a Krogan warlord with a pack of playing cards once.
A pack of cards?
Choking hazard, apparently.
Wow. See you later, Cora.
I'll be here.
I wish she didn't hate me so much. Ugh, I have to take this.
You're not Harry.
The blue give it away? Habitat 7 was a little more action-packed than Harry bargained for. He decided to spend his retirement years in the Hyperion looking after your brother.
Joke's on him. Scott's a handful.
I think you're both trouble. Hold still.
Ow!
Sorry.
I remember you having a gentler touch.
Still trying to get my bearings. Thought I'd be waking up colonists, not taking care of the Pathfinder.
I couldn't be in better hands.
I just stabbed you.
We all have off days.
I always hoped to work in the field, but everything's happening so quickly.
Focus on the positive. It helps.
I guess this is my opportunity to study alien species firsthand. Getting a Ket specimen aboard the Hyperion would be difficult, but here...
What?
A Ket corpse. For autopsy.
Oh, okay.
A live subject would be better, but I'm not greedy.
Why do you care about the Ket?
Harry didn't tell you? I'm a specialist in alien anatomy. My thesis on Krogan virility and aggression is what got me in the initiative.
Oh my god, why am I so attracted to blue ladies? First, what was her name? Lori, Liara, now this. I can't help it, guys. If we find somebody else I like better, you know, it's fine.
I had no idea. I'd love to hear more. Over dinner, maybe.
Oh.
Oh,
thing is,
no.
Ryder, you're not my type.
What's your type?
Not a patient. I need to be able to look at you clinically without distractions.
Am I distracting?
Not nearly as much as you think you are.
Oh.
But we were discussing the Ket. An autopsy could teach us potential weaknesses, average lifespan.
Right.
Just something to think about. Sam, make sure the Pathfinder eats her vegetables.
I actually feel kind of hurt.
So we have a stowaway.
You mean PB?
She's decided to set up in one of the escape pods. You don't need a psychologist to tell you that one's got commitment issues.
How did you get into medicine?
My mum was a dancer on Omega. Dad was a bouncer. I'd patch him up after busy nights. Discovered I had steady hands. They put every credit they earned into my education.
Aww.
Are they here in Helios?
No. Both died in a turf war. Made leaving the Milky Way behind easier.
How do you think the crew is holding up?
I'm happy to share what I can without violating patient confidentiality. Anyone in particular? I sort them in their files and my brain by species.
How do you think the human crew members are handling things?
There's a lot of them.
Oh, God, there is.
How's Cora doing?
She's processing. Your father was her mentor. She expected to follow in his footsteps, but he gave the role of Pathfinder to you. Just because she trusts his judgment doesn't mean she's not confused. Or hurt.
Gil?
Gil likes to use humor as a defensive technique. He'd rather bury himself in the Nomad than tackle emotions head on.
Suvi okay?
She's remarkably adaptive. I'm kind of jealous.
How's Liam?
A handful. Every time I patch him up, he breaks something new. Liam's we can't lose attitude is commendable. But I worry how he'll react when something does go wrong.
I'd like to check in on the non-human crew.
Ask away.
Is PB all right?
She's avoiding me. Probably thinks I'll poke her with a needle if she gets too close.
To be fair, you're always giving me shots.
Not in the hallway.
Tell me about Vetra.
Vetra's used to having someone depend on her. I think that's why she's so resourceful and likes providing for other people. That being said, I think she could use a little me time.
How's our Solarian?
Me time.
He's quite the gossip. Tight-lipped about himself, though.
Is Drac good?
That old bastard's always good. I've never met anyone who can be so stubborn and so appreciative. Could you look out for him, Ryder?
Oh, she likes him.
Don't worry, Lexi. I'll keep an eye on him.
Thank you. And maybe
she
don't mention
likes
my
him.
Thanks for the insight. I need to talk to you about something private.
Of course. That's what I'm here for.
When Dad died, he blocked off parts of Sam's memory. Things he didn't want me to see.
Or he thought you weren't ready for.
Maybe. I found this trigger. It unlocked a memory fragment of Dad on the Citadel. From when the Alliance rejected his ideas about AI, and he found out Mom's illness was terminal.
Why do you think your father chose this specific memory?
It was where his journey to Andromeda really began.
Those events started your family down a new path.
Yeah. Thanks, Lexi. Feels good to talk about this. How long have you and Harry been friends?
I remember when he didn't complain about arthritis. We met at a medical convention on the Citadel. He was moderating a panel on neurosurgery in low-gravity environments. His name card was crooked, but he was so damn confident, I knew we'd be friends.
So how'd an Asari doctor end up on the human arc?
Specialist in alien anatomy, remember? That includes humans. Also, Harry insisted. Maybe he always intended to switch jobs.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
She rejected me, guys. I feel so hurt. They're like, let me dangle this in front of you. Oh, by the way.
Don't give the Pathfinder too much trouble. Oh, Roshan.
Who are you talking to?
Kesh, Nexus Superintendent, thinks she can boss me around just because she's my granddaughter.
Oh, she's his granddaughter? Daughter?
Well, welcome to the Tempest. Trouble's what we do.
I like the way you think, kid.
Ugh, someone somewhere shivered when I said that.
Probably Tan. Damn politicians.
Is that all you brought?
You travel lean when supplies are tight and you're on your own.
Leaving the Nexus can't have been an easy choice.
It was, actually. Staying became impossible. After the mutiny happened, it was either buckle under Tan's rules or start our own colony. Easy choice. Bad consequences all around.
Not all Krogan left. Your granddaughter stayed.
Good thing she did. Without my Roshan, you wouldn't have had much of a station to tie your ship to. As for me, I'm way more useful out here. Lots to shoot at, for one.
I do understand why you love them.
Our people come first.
Keeping Kesh and our colony safe will always be my top priority. That's why I'm happy to tag along, help make this galaxy a little more hospitable.
Can't argue with that.
Ryder, you meet Spender yet? Colonial Affairs, the ass in assistant director. Got no idea why Addison keeps him around. Spender lied to the Krogan during the uprising, and he's headed out for Kesh ever since. He's up to something. I just can't prove it. We should pay him a visit on the Nexus.
What's it like to have Kesh as a granddaughter?
Kesh is my Rushan, child of my blood. Raised her myself. Damn proud of her, too. She did good, even with me for a granddad.
She's honest. Definitely blunt.
She had to take after me in some ways, I guess.
Did Lexi brief you on Sam and squad connectivity yet?
Yeah. You want to hook that thing up to my comms, sure, but that's where it stops. Putting an AI in your head, giving it access to everything like that, it's begging for trouble.
Why do you say that?
I've seen what bots can do when they turn on their creators. Been in some of those fights.
Right.
There's a reason that kind of research was outlawed.
Yeah, my peacekeeping career went up in smoke when news of what my dad was researching got out.
No shit. Ruined the writer name, I'll bet.
Almost. I'm not thrilled about it myself, but it is what it is.
Just make sure it can't unshackle itself. There'll be hell to pay if that happens.
I'd like to know more about you.
Fire away.
How did you and Vetra meet?
Huh, that's right. Your father brought you into the project pretty late, didn't he? Must have been a pretty steep learning curve since they thawed you out.
You could say that.
You make do with what you get. Anyway, I met Vetra back when we were building the Nexus. She swiped supplies I was trying to get for Kesh right under my nose. I tried to intimidate her into turning them over to me, and let me tell you, that Turian takes shit from no one.
She's pretty awesome that way, I agree.
She really has a way of getting things done.
She sure does.
Oh.
But here's the best part. She waited until I saw her again in Kesh's office, no less, to tell me she'd been working for Kesh all along. They're both still laughing at me over that.
Tell me more about the Krogan colony.
My clan's there. We also got some scouts looking for any unclaimed territory to grab up. Got a decent setup going. Self-sustainable, the works. Even some farming.
Farming? Krogan farm?
Food's food. Just because we can eat anything doesn't mean we gotta settle for scraps.
Respect.
I'm pretty fond of Corkrow roots myself. Takes a while to chew through those.
So, about all this combat experience you have, I'd love some details.
Ha! The list will be shorter if you ask me what experience I don't have. I've been doing this for a long time now. Centuries. Shit, well over 1,000 years. Don't even know how I'm still alive, to be honest.
Skill?
You need luck to be a merc. Skill, sure, but a whole lot of luck.
Hey, life is all about luck.
Why did the Krogan leave the Nexus?
The Nexus got us Krogan to stop the mutiny. In return, we were supposed to get a say in station business. Spender, Addison's assistant, lied about the deal, and Tan came down hard. Too hard. So we left. Kesh is alone on that station now.
You think someone might try to hurt Kesh?
Ah, more like she airlocks Spender. Or he tries to stab her in the back, and then she airlocks him.
Nice.
Tan wouldn't listen to me when I told him Spender had a part in the mutiny. I had no proof.
So what's my part in this?
Things need to get sorted out and my clan needs to get back on station without Spender messing things up. Way I see it, you're probably the best one for that job.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
Hey, one last thing.
Yeah?
Is everyone a kid to you?
Ha, when you get to be my age, yeah, pretty much.
Cute. Oh yeah, my room. Okay, let's see. Do I have everyone?
Hey, I'm in storage if you need me.
Why are you in storage, boy?
I'll talk to someone. Maybe they could use you on comms.
So you get to be with the Pathfinder, and I have to watch your radio?
The radio, or help Kesh with cleanup.
Oh.
Oh, hey, Pathfinder.
The Pathfinder's there? Let me say hi.
Fine, but don't embarrass me. Ryder, this is Sid, my sister. Sid, Ryder.
Let me guess. Little sister?
Who are you calling little?
Look, kiddo, gotta go.
Wait, Ryder, I just wanted to know if...
So I know it feels like I just jumped aboard your ship without explanation.
I would have done the same just to get off the Nexus.
That's not why I came. Sure, I want to explore the galaxy, but I'm really here to work. I know everyone on the crew, even the actuators Gil prefers for the ship. Better, I know how to get my hands on them. With me around, your crew's going to be at their best. We've been failing for months, Ryder. Now that we have you, we have a chance out here.
Do I just get to hit on everyone? Or like... No. No.
Ability to haggle with the locals? Great. But please tell me you're also good in a fight.
Like I said before, wrangler, provisioner, gunner, and everything in between, I do what I have to. We all have a personal stake in this. If it keeps going the way it's been, we're all dead. I should track down a lead for Gil's actuators. Back channels, you know. We'll chat later?
No, we're gonna chat now.
Terraforming, Atmo processors, gravity wells, life destroying. We really had no idea what Helios was about, did we?
If we knew what it was all about, it wouldn't be an adventure. It would just be moving, and everyone hates moving. Just the packing alone. Bleh.
Point taken. I'm just saying. I really hope you have a plan, Ryder.
The plan's the same. We find a home. Whatever that takes.
Keep that drive. Makes me believe we can make it. I mean, we have to make it. The alternative is not even worth thinking about.
You were on the Nexus when the revolt happened?
When you promise people golden worlds and all they get are wastelands and a death cloud, they riot. Some wanted to go home, some demanded answers, and a couple just wanted to stir shit up.
And you?
Some days I wondered if the exiles had a point. Maybe we were conned into coming here. But why would the initiative go to all this trouble just to screw us over? Thing about conning people, you always know something they don't. And that's why the con works. And if I'm going to pick a side, I'm picking the liars.
You talked about your back channels. What did you mean?
We brought a lot from home. Some of it marked initiative, some of it in personal caches. Most things you want, someone's got. You just have to figure out who, and what they're willing to take in exchange.
That just sounds like you're taking advantage of people.
Is it? I get people what they want, and they do want, or they wouldn't pay.
Have anyone else here with you? Besides Sid?
No, just me and Sid. It's always been just the two of us.
No, I mean, someone special.
Special? Oh. You mean like... Oh. No, nothing like that. Who has time? What about you?
Anywhere's gonna feel empty if you don't have someone to share it with.
A romantic? I wasn't expecting that. Then again, the entire idea of leaving everything you know for a chance at something new is kind of romantic. Anyway.
How did she hear of the Andromeda Initiative?
Short answer. I thought it was.
Okay.
I asked and she told me about the initiative. New Galaxy. You know where to find me.
Yes, goodbye. I feel like we're almost done.
Pathfinder, help me with something. I know, not exactly standard. Gotta make the space comfortable. Plus, the fabric diffuses the charge from an overclocked Omni blade. Not giving up a 6% boost, right?
Right, right. What?
Never mind. BS for the requisition. So, finally time for that beer?
Hey.
And after 2 years and a dozen suspensions, I took a lateral promotion out of the force. Being a cop just didn't fit. But crisis response? Digging people out of trouble? That worked. I bet Hustle followed you into a few peace actions. Think about your alliance days much?
Tell me about your group.
Heavy urban search terrain one? Yeah. Earth's contribution to a multi-species disaster response unit. HUST-1, but Hustle looks much better on the patch. All civilians, retired vets, or shits like me. I was fiercely bearded. Tastes better just thinking about those days.
I wanted exploration, to chase the cutting edge of Prothean research. I thought I'd found my calling. Seems like a long time ago.
600 years, give or take. So, Pathfinder, why Andromeda?
That blunt, huh?
That blunt.
I was on a good path in the Alliance. Then everything fell apart. There wasn't much left for me. Andromeda was so far away, I figured if you're going to start over, start way over.
Gotcha. Clean slate. Classic.
Back at you, Costa. Why do you come?
I want to say I'm running from my past, but really running from myself. That'd be a great story. But it's bullshit. I had family, friends, a good enough job, nothing was wrong. I just heard about the initiative and I believed in it. I believed in a new beginning. Still do. I have to. We're in it.
We can't go back, but we're not trapped by decisions a galaxy behind us.
I don't feel trapped. We came from a good place for good reasons. But keep that in mind or steer us right, just like back in crisis response. Remember the essentials. A new start guided by the Pathfinder. And team. I'll bust my tail to make that a good story.
Hey. Drink.
Okay. We started Pathfinder. A new life. That is goddamn brilliant.
Just wondering what you think of how I'm doing at the job.
I'm committed to the initiative. Your Pathfinder. It's as simple as it gets.
You barely covered how you joined. Tell me something about yourself.
Alright. I was a bad student, piss poor cop, great responder. Had a good life, but it all been done. I wasn't looking to start over. I wanted to start big.
You were a cop, then crisis response? Couldn't have been long in either.
Didn't have the patience for law, so I figured enforcement. Dad knew it didn't fit before I did. But it got me into Hustle. They mostly take vets and retired service. Best years of my life.
An impatient rookie, frustrated by procedure. That's overdone.
I know, right? I wanted new, and I got it. And that led me here.
Tell me about your family.
I miss the hell out of them. Some nights you just cry, right? That's the thing everyone does.
Wow.
Mom, Joelle. Dad, Calvin. Both lawyers. Met on the Citadel, settled on Earth. No brothers or sisters. That might have been too much to leave. It was traditional. How about you?
Life with my family was not typical on a number of fronts.
You may do though, right? Family has to. I know mine did. I said goodbye to my mom and dad and got on a ship to Andromeda.
We'll talk later.
It's really not that easy, bro. Are we missing anybody, guys? only took a half an hour. Great. Oh, do I need to go here? Oh, I do.
Pathfinder, making the rounds. Slumming it, huh? Want to see how the riffraff are making out?
Hey, it's a dirty job. Are you the riffraff spokesman?
King, actually. You might want to bow. Otherwise, no telling what might fall off the nomad when you're out there.
I'll take my chances. Just want to see how things are going with the ship.
I can coax more out of this baby than some might think, but we shouldn't go too far or push too hard between Nexus stops. For now. It just feels good to be stretching our wings, you know? Locked in idle too long, you start to drift. People, same as ships. Stuck on the Nexus, gotta say, I was regretting joining the Initiative.
Seems like life back there was pretty bleak.
Not gonna lie, it sucked. I tend to live the way I work. Kind of feel it, do it. Not a lot of close ties. No real sense of purpose. Figured maybe I'd find my true calling in Andromeda. Then I got here and, oops, I just made a decision there's no turning back from. I was going nuts on that station. You can't know how jazzed I was when you showed up.
Oh, why can I flirt with all these people? Oh my god, should I try? Okay.
Happy to be of service. I think you'll see that showing up is only one of my many talents.
Oh yeah? You're not hitting on me, are you?
Thought I was. Is it not one of my many talents?
I'm just not susceptible, if you know what I mean. Liam's more my speed.
Oh,
well,
no.
If he wasn't such a tool.
Got it. Sorry.
No sweat at all. You just keep pointing this ship wherever you want it to go, and I'll make sure she can get there. Deal?
Deal.
Dang it, I'm so embarrassed, man.
Long time no chat. What's up?
Seems like we have a good group here.
Well, Vetra and Suvi are my girls. Get along well. Lots of mutual respect. PB's a real spark plug. I like her, but she's exhausting. And Drak's my kind of guy. Brash. Takes no shit. As far as your Hyperion peeps go, the doc's kind of nosy. Liam's good for a laugh or two. Cora, she's a bit by the book for me.
Need somebody to keep the zoo in check.
Zoo? You calling me an animal rider? Ooh, can I be a mongoose? They're like cool cobra killers. No, wait, how about a crow? Smart, irreverent, obnoxious. That's it.
I'll take your word for it. What about Kello?
He's a pilot.
Which means?
He flies the ship.
We're leaving it at that then?
Does a Pathfinder know what to do with a dead end?
I hear we have you to thank for getting the Tempest space ready so quickly.
Vetra brings her impossible feats to me. I was itching to get this particular call. Capital R, ready. Don't tell her, but the truth is, I fudge reports to come in early, then bust ass in secret to make up for it. Expands the guild legend. Plus, I convey calm and assurance, and the whole team relaxes, which helps them do their jobs better.
What's your social circle like?
I'm good for a laugh, so I know lots of people, but I don't let too many in. My one true friend is stationed on the Nexus. She's the only piece of the Milky Way I brought with me. The more you and I get to know each other, the more you'll probably hear about her.
How tough was it on the Nexus all those months?
Have you ever eaten overcooked space cow tongue?
Hasn't everyone?
Well, then you know. It's super tough. Wondering if you're gonna die from a critical malfunction? Or maybe starvation? Imagining which would be worse? But hey, you could always take a break from the fear and boredom to dwell on being a part of the biggest failure in galactic history. Maybe even participate in a revolt.
What was your take on that?
I didn't place any bets, if that's what you're asking. Truth is, I don't think anyone made out particularly well. Whatever side you're on, you die a little when your brother, your teammate, becomes an enemy. We traveled all this way, all hope and wonder, and we end up fighting with each other over scraps. It's sad.
Good talking to you, Gil.
Anytime.
haven't really spoken since orientation, have we?
It's all been so hectic, but I'm...
Five images of fairies. What? Oh, everybody's just emailing me. Okay.
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon.
Darkly beautiful. I like that. Helios is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it, so alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
You mean a god?
Yes, I believe in a higher power. I know it's a little odd, but I am a scientist because science brings me closer to something greater than myself.
There's something about coming face to face with something wondrous that makes you want to believe.
Wow. It's wonderful to meet someone who understands. I've had to justify myself so often. As if having faith in the divine invalidated my work as a scientist. As if the sacred could be diminished by the search for truth.
I wasn't questioning your abilities. You never have to justify yourself to me.
Thank you. I appreciate you saying that, truly.
My science
teacher
is religious.
I should probably update the rest of the team with my latest reports. We'll talk later.
Sure.
I saw Pic- And how much of it didn't you see? What if it's way bigger?
Wild Remnant Park-
Oh, joking. I see. Good one.
I like you. We'll talk later. Oh, okay. Enough talking. I can't. Oh, we're just gonna go to Esos to do more talking, aren't we? Yep. I'll talk to them before.
here for months. Still not enough time to survey it all. I'm picking up something. Probe away. Anomaly found.
I have a lot of things to do. This feels like home.
Pathfinder, is it true? We're settling Eos.
We've thought that before.
But Eos is different now, right? Pathfinder.
All right, settle down. Give him space. Lieutenant Syax, Kendros' aide. They all wanted to see you. Real hope again. It's been a while.
Relax, Lieutenant. If there was ever a day to pop some champagne.
Certainly. The initiative's finally back on track.
Professor Herrick, right?
What you achieve with that remnant vault is unprecedented, Pathfinder. Impossible. But with new scientific talent waking up, we'll unravel those mysteries. The whole Nexus will benefit.
We've taken some hard knocks, but this proves we'll always get up again.
Always.
Well, what are you waiting for? There's a new world out there.
Thank you, Ryder.
Aw, I like when they call me Ryder instead of Pathfinder.
Pathfinder, do you have just a minute?
Sure.
Ryder, isn't it? Kerry Tvesa, freelance vidmaker. This is Hakim, my producer.
I could use your help.
What are you looking for?
Director Tans asked for an uplifting documentary on the initiative. Translation, paint rainbows over our problems. But our problems are history. People deserve the truth, not propaganda.
It takes integrity to record the truth and nothing but.
Well, I do my best. And you could help me out. The heart of my documentary will be an interview series. I was hoping you'd take part. I want the dirt and blood of our story, not the convenient fairy tale Tan's looking for. Interested?
Hell yeah. I don't care if you piss off Tan.
Interview away.
Let's start at home. 14 months and the Nexus still isn't finished. Arcs are missing, we have people in exile. By any standard, this wasn't the plan. Our leadership describes these as anticipated issues. Would you agree?
We still have to fix them. Everyone, leaders included, needs to pitch in. Let's be honest about these challenges and how we're going to face them.
Nice. Won't make you popular with the leaders, but it's good to hear. Bandwidth means I'm transmitting in short bursts, so that's all for now. But you can bet I'll have more questions later. You were great. I'll get to work editing.
Who said I was trying to be popular with the leaders?
Hello. Director Tan is expecting you.
Last time I was here, this was a storage closet.
Pathfinder Hall just needed a Pathfinder to open.
We're still getting the commons area ready. Hydroponics is only at partial capacity.
Not good enough.
We don't have enough people. My workers need a break, Tan.
I sympathize, but not until our survival is no longer at risk. Now please excuse me while I meet with our Pathfinder. Hey, Ryder. Addison told me about the outpost. You're the hero of the hour.
Let's hold off on the celebration. We haven't found home yet.
Oh, there's no need for modesty. Success affords leverage over those who doubted you.
And you're my best friend.
A patron. One who shares your vision of a prosperous future.
I suppose we agree on that much.
I knew that given a chance, your talents would emerge. Deciphering the vault, alien terraforming. It's not how we imagined all this, but a good Pathfinder improvises. And a great one hangs it on the wall.
What?
Yours are the first trophies to grace Pathfinder Hall. You're a symbol now, Ryder. A reason for people to believe.
I plan on doing a lot more than that.
That's the confidence we need. Take charge and ignore your critics.
Careful, you'll end up adopting you, Ryder.
Ah, my staff.
Colleagues, you wouldn't be looking to cut us out, would you, Tan?
I remind you, I am the director of the initiative.
Acting director.
This isn't the time for arguing over who gets to be king. Too much is at stake. We should be cooperating.
That's what I've been saying since we arrived.
Then I look forward to winning our Pathfinder support.
I have concerns about your decision on Eos, Ryder. An outpost full of scientists won't do as much good if the Ket attack.
But it will help support the Nexus. Improved research could help feed our people.
And we could argue about it all day long, as we always do. The decision was made. Now we move on. What is your plan for moving on, Ryder?
We have a lead on the terraforming network. I need to take the Tempest deeper into the sector to investigate. If the other Golden Worlds are where they should be, this could get us closer to them.
Careful. The Ket are scouring the cluster for remnant technology. You'll end up in a fight, for sure.
I'll be fine.
You might also run into exiles. They didn't leave the Nexus on good terms.
And we still need more outposts. They're important to expanding the station.
Though with Ark still missing, this could be a chance for Ryder to search for them. Yes, I think that's best. You have my permission.
I don't need
I wasn't permission. Really asking for it.
Of course. I support that kind of enthusiasm.
Right.
Ryder, this is Harry, back on the Ark.
Go ahead.
We may have found a way to talk to your brother, sort of. Drop by when you can. Hyperion Medbay.
Will do.
Pathfinder, we are to contact Director Addison as
SR Normandy.
Soon as possible.
Right. She had something that could help with our job.
Whole mood of the Nexus has changed since Eos. You really can feel it.
outpost, a Pathfinder's help, people waking up. It's a fresh start.
Third time's a charm, if you happen to have a Pathfinder around.
Can't always rely on luck. From here, it's hard work. But it's damn good to know we're on the right track.
Oh, yeah. It's a little weird, honestly. I haven't done that much yet.
You've had a year to think about it.
Ryder, you're off to a promising start. I meant what I said. You are a symbol now of hope that things will get better. Though I worry about this terraforming network. What do we really know about it?
It's like nothing we've ever seen. It's clear somebody had big plans for this cluster.
But who?
Not sure yet, but at least we're on the trail.
Did you have some other business?
Nope.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
I'm here to serve.
Hydroponics reports oxygen production is nominal.
Cora, you're jealous. Just back off, please.
Hi there.
That is not...
Welcome back, Pathfinder. As personnel transfer to EOS, be sure every colonist has their survival kit and please select a topic.
Okay, I don't care. They've really changed up the place.
Glad to see you finally. I hear you've been busy out there.
That's one word for it.
If you need anything, come see me, even if it's just a vent.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
Any logistics updates are...
Weekly injury report. Minimum casualties. A good week.
Sid?
You! You're the human
Pathfinder! Oh, Sid!
I'm Sid, Vetra's sister. Vetra's told me all about you. Well, not all about you, but the important bits. I should probably get back to work. It was real nice meeting you, though.
What work do you do here?
Oh, I just monitor comms from colonists. Progress updates, hazards encountered. Note it down, pass on a report to Sean at the end of the day.
Important job.
I know. It's nice to hand in a report and have someone say I helped.
I'll let you get back to work.
Cool, we got to meet with her.
A correction? Is it a factual error? Pathfinder. Wow. I'm Davis Carr, Helios News Service. Maybe you've heard my voice over the vids. I'm trying to file a story right now, but hey.
HNS, huh? Where are the rest of you?
I had an editor, but it's crazy out here. Now, beyond a freelancer or two, I'm it. All that stands between freedom and tyranny, or something. I haven't had much sleep.
I met another journalist, Carrie Tavessa.
Yeah, we're running Carrie's series, Path of a Hero. Good stuff. I'm mostly on my own, so pretty much anyone who brings me news is welcome. Content is king, and her content is really touching a nerve.
It must be difficult to set up a broadcast from scratch.
No, it's easy. Beyond the lack of staff, resistant authorities, and constant technical glitches. Still, I'm getting there. May have an honest-to-goodness source in Nexus Security, if she ever calls me back.
Who's your source?
No journalist worth their salt will ever give that up.
Who pays for you to do this?
Technically, H&S is an arm of the initiative, but we serve the public, not them. Sometimes the higher-ups try and tell us what to broadcast, Tan especially, but we decide what to run and how to run it. It causes friction, but at least I can live with myself.
Yes, honesty is the best policy.
Were you a journalist back in the Milky Way?
I was. Sort of. Only had a couple internships under my belt. Good places, though. The New Star Chronicle even sent me to Mars for a week. The plan was just to work as a reporter out here. Then the uprising happened. We got a little too close. My editor was killed.
Oh, shit.
Tan blamed our broadcasts for stirring unrest. It was bullshit. Now all I want to do is keep going.
Talk to you later, Davis.
Hey, Ryder, before you go, I hate to ask, but it seems like your job takes you all over. The places we can't broadcast yet. If I send receivers to your ship, would you mind placing them on some planets? It'll help get news out to even the most far-flung colonists.
What do you need from me exactly?
I'm digging up good story. I need someone to place receivers and boost our signal.
Okay, Dave.
Great. Just...
Alright, let's deal with Nilkin, and then we're gonna call it an episode. And we still have more people to talk to anyway.
Let's puke on the floor. I'm gonna get sick. You're sick. Locking a man up with germs. If I die, I'm gonna sue your asses.
Keep blowing that hot air, pal. It'll dry out fast.
I hear you went down to Eos. Did you find anything to help my case?
You're a liar. The chief's Omnitool recorded you over the body, admitting to killing him.
What? Wait, that's not... What are you trying to pull?
Sam, playback.
Sorry, old friend. Had to do it. I'm not dying on this rock. Well, shit. Guess my fate is sealed.
Except that your shot missed. A kep blast to the back killed Reynolds.
Are you serious? I'm innocent. What a stroke of luck. The conviction will have to be overturned. The sentence thrown out.
I'm going to Tan, and I might have a different opinion. You did try to cover it all up.
Look, I'm sorry I lied, but if my shot missed, I'm innocent, plain and simple.
We'll see about that.
Yeah, what about, like, attempted murder or something? Do we have time to talk to Tan? We got time to talk to Tan. 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 I like the way her hair bounces. It's cute.
Hello, Pathfinder.
Hey, bit. Oh, I mean... young lady.
Well, old man, we're getting there.
We're seeing more and more skirmishes with the cat.
Something I can help you with?
Director, I checked out that murder. Nilkin didn't do it, but there's proof that he meant to.
This is unfortunate. We're trying to give the people a sense of stability, leadership they think they can count on. And we're setting precedent for justice here in Andromeda. Now this. A convicted murderer who didn't commit the murder.
I hear you. It sucks when things aren't black and white.
Are they ever? If we suppress the evidence and uphold the conviction, we're banishing a man for a crime he technically didn't commit. If we throw the conviction out, we're freeing a man who tried to matters into his own hands.
Oops.
Then covered it up. Your investigation complicated this. You should take responsibility for the outcome. Do we still exile him for murder?
What? Oh, man. hears it. He wanted to kill the guy, but his shot missed. He did shoot the guy, but do we exile him then? Why is it just these two options? Why can't I choose something a little bit more, like keep him in prison? Do we still exile him for murder?
It was crazy down there. Life and death. But his shot didn't kill Reynolds. We have to let him go.
You're a bottom line type of person. I hope we don't regret it. Alright, so be it. He will do community service for his role in the chaos. But he's a free man. Well, at least we'll have the sordid business behind us.
Yeah. Ugh. Intense. Very, very intense. I know I have to do all of that. Okay, just looking at what we have, so that's kind of where we are, essentially. Pretty annoying. That was tricky, but I can't exile him for something he didn't do. But, yeah, that's kind of how it is, so we're gonna pick up again next week. I know we did a lot of talking, and unfortunately... No, we're going to be running around. Yeah, we're going to be doing a bit of talking. And then we're going to most likely going to go to EEO's. Because that's just kind of the way I work. I like finishing up everything before I go back. So yeah, that's kind of what we're going to be doing. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Mass Effect Andromeda. If you did, please leave a like, a comment, and a subscribe. Bye!